mental health, myself Anuradha. Today I've come up with a very brilliant topic. You all might really like it. So the topic is how to stop taking things personally. It does happen that many of us do, sometimes feel low if somebody has passed a comment on us or behave very differently or badly with us. We don't like it, right? And that's very much natural. That's okay. But sometimes few people who are really emotionally not so strong can take it to heart and can feel so bad. So here, people who take things to heart or personally, they need to use certain practices wherein they can help themselves and not really feel so bad. Because if you will continue to feel bad or take things personally, that will harm your mental emotional state and mental state, right? So I am, without wasting much of the time, I will share the first thing what you can do is. The first thing is realize. You need to realize that if whatever the person has commented or behaved with you, does that make any sense? Or if it is really worth it or true? Because you are the better judge and you know very well that where the things were wrong and if it were wrong or not wrong. If it was right from your end, then let it be. It definitely is right, right? And you need not to think more. But if you think that whatever the person has said is right and you are just trying to get into a lot of depression or sadness, that is how you are doing, you're not doing justice with you. That's a wrong behavior. You need to understand yourself and you should not take things personally. Realize that there can be certain reasons behind the person might have said things. There can be situations due to which the person has said. So you need to realize, have an understanding, and you have to let go. The next one is ask yourself. So when some situation has happened that has made you feel so low and bad, you need to ask yourself that what is the reason? There can be million reasons behind a person's behavior, a person's criticism. And I want to tell you one thing, that whatever the person has commented or behaved with you, that reflects their personality, not your personality. So if you want to understand this thing, you have to keep this in mind, that whatever they have behaved is their problem. They might be going through something, that is how they might be so rude or bad with you. So ask yourself and feel better, and there can be certain and many reasons behind which you need to tell your mind, and you have to calm yourself. Next one is accept the criticism. Criticisms generally help us in a way to let us grow better in life. It does happen that when we get criticism, if we take it negatively, we can feel so sad and we can literally destroy ourselves. But if we try to take criticisms in a constructive way or in a positive way, this can help us to become a better version of ourselves, right? So try to take the criticism in a positive way and in a constructive way to focus on to become a good person and improve from what has happened, right? If you will take things personally and feel low, that is a wrong behavior. So here you need to change yourself and think positively. And the next one is understand. Understand that you cannot please the whole world, and we are not meant to please the whole world or the entire world, right? We connect with people who are best for us and who we matches well with, and we cannot make friends with the whole world. Why? Because we have a certain nature. Our personality is like the way we attract people, and our mindset sometimes like our mindset that do match with certain people, and that is how we become friends to them. So you need to understand this thing. You cannot please the whole world, and you can connect well with those who are good with you, and you should stay only with people who are good for your mental health, right? So here you need to understand that you are not meant to please the whole world. And the next one is tell yourself that your self-worth doesn't depend on others, that depends on your own self. So you need to take care of your self-worth. Whatever the other people may say or behave with you, that doesn't define you. You know who you are, your friends know, your family know you, and the people whom you are connected to, they all know you very well. So you need not to tell or define or justify your self-worth to others. You need to justify it to your own self, only to your own self. That is the very important thing you need to understand. And the next very important thing I want to say is, whenever anything happens that upsets you or makes you feel really sad, you need to understand it with a different perspective. Think that what other person who might be a stranger or who doesn't know the situation very well, how would he or she react to the situation, who is unbiased. So just think in that perspective, just change a little bit of your perspective, then think of the situation, that is it worth it that you are feeling so sad? Is it really, really worth it that whatever has happened and you are taking it personally? How would the other person react to this situation? If you will calmly think, you will come to a conclusion and understand that you are wasting your time thinking too much. And you are the best person, and you should definitely focus on to become a better version of yourself and never ever get into the circle of depression. Or you should not think how others are taking you. You know yourself, and that is all matters a lot. So I really want to say that thanks for watching me. I hope you really like listening. And if you really do, you can comment, you can like, share and subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching. See you next time.